Monday Nitro continues live in the Market Square Arena in Indianapolis. We'll remind you that Monday, June 1st, Nitro comes to the MCI Center in the nation's capital, Washington, D.C. Tickets are still on sale at the box office and Ticketmaster. And on Monday, June 8th, WCW Monday Nitro comes to the Palace of Auburn Hills, right outside of Metropolitan Detroit. Tickets available at the box office and all Ticketmaster locations. And what a weekend it was for ticket sales in Nassau, the Nassau Coliseum in Long Island, Mike.
Well, we keep reminding the WCW fans about how important those first day ticket sales are. Why don't you ask someone in New York? Upcoming Nitro event on Long Island at Nassau Coliseum, I understand, Tony, sold out in about a half an hour this past Saturday.
Look, did you see, was that Alex Wright in the ring?
They heard I was coming.
There's Alex Wright.
Where's security when you need him?
Interrupting the Nitro girls. Boy, this night continues to get even more. There comes security as they finally lock this guy away again. Take a special look at what Hollywood Hogan had to say 1 week ago right here on this program.
Oh, my disciples.
1 week ago, interesting comments and things that have been going on in professional wrestling over the past couple of weeks. And Hogan and Bischoff had the power, you know, to keep people off of this television program, be it in lawsuits or with personal problems. They've had the ability to... Actually, we haven't seen Scott Hall in quite a while. And now the question remains... It's supposed to be Scott Hall and Kevin Nash defending the World Tag Team belts coming up on the 17th at Slamboree, but we're wondering if Scott Hall is really going to show up.
That was an awful newsworthy and very eventful Wolfpack interview earlier this evening on Nitro, and among the most interesting comments from Kevin Nash were that Hollywood Hogan and Eric Bischoff apparently were plotting and that his partner is too dangerous for live television. We haven't seen Scott Hall now, and it's been well over a month, and now we're inside 2 weeks before Slamboree. One has to question whether Scott Hall is going to join Kevin Nash and Slamboree to defend the tag team titles.
Ben,
they're not waiting.
That's a question that we have to talk about and discuss and wonder during the course of this program. But right now, we're in the midst of what has been now billed as a return bout and a street fight between these two teams. And that means basically anything goes. It's Public Enemy against the team of Humorous and the Barbarian with Jimmy Hart. And I do understand that Jimmy Hart, because of the street fight rules, can get involved in this match as well, because basically anything goes. And Jimmy Hart does just that.
This is a matchup that Jimmy Hart demanded, a return bout. We saw a Philadelphia street fight between these two teams several months back. Then last Monday, from Norfolk, a street fight. Now we're here in Indianapolis with another return bout.
As you can see, already things are happening here. Watch out!
They garbage all over the place in there.
They've got garbage cans. They've got the top of that can. Did you hear that one?
Thud.
That was more than a thud. It was like a boink on top of the head.
A boink?
It was like a steel plate in the head. Oh, my goodness.
There's an opposite of a boink.
That's what that was, Larry. And he's caught up on the top ropes as Rocco Rock. Meanwhile, Johnny Grunge. Just wailing away here on Hugh Morris.
A day for a street fight. You got four of the perfect components. All four of these guys are nuts, and that's what's left of Rocco.
Rocco Rock looking like he dropped some change into the garbage can, looking for it, and then he gets downed by the Barbarian. Boy, as wild as it can be. And, of course, you know, this is exactly what Public Enemy likes.
They love this.
Oh, my goodness.
And I don't see Hugh Morris and the Barbarian backing away from this battle either.
They're as tough as they come, and they're ready and willing for the battle as well. The battle continues in this street fight we have for you here on WCW Monday Nitro. And what? It wouldn't be a street fight with Public Enemy without that patented table. And here it is on the outside.
They got Grunge on it. They don't count Jimmy Hart out physically. He's no threat, but mentally, he knows what he's doing. And the Public Enemy have to keep an eye on what Jimmy Hart is doing in there.
Watch out. Johnny Grunge is on the table. The Barbarian.
How far away he is.
He's a high flyer. Oh, my goodness.
He saw the Barbarian coming.
Oh, boy. The Barbarian may have really injured an arm that time. May have broken an arm, injured a bicep. Up on top now is Rocco. Oh, my goodness. He hits another table.
He press slammed Rocco Rock right through the wooden table.
Incredible. And now Jimmy Hart. Oh, he nails Hugh Morris. Jimmy Hart does not have his men with him at all.
Jimmy Hart is in trouble.
Sure, look at that body.
that Jimmy Hart you don't normally see. And a big slam by Johnny Grunge. Johnny Grunge!
Oh, big splash!
The big splash! This one is over! So Jimmy Hart wanted it, Mike Tenay. Wanted to be involved, and in the end, his team loses to Public Enemy.
Be careful what you ask for. Jimmy Hart just found out firsthand. Go ahead, Larry.
Not the first time Jimmy Hart self-sacrificed himself, but I think this is the worst Jimmy Hart ever got it.
As they peel Jimmy Hart off the mat, we go to meet Gene Okerlund.
All right, Tony, I thank you very much. We've got a lot of things happening here tonight on WCW Monday Nitro. Battle lines drawn earlier between the members of the NWO. I noticed back here in the holding area one man I wanted to bring out. He is a member of the New World Order. Please welcome Brian Adams. Brian. Tony, Mike, Larry, I want to see if we can get this thing sorted out.
Well, I'm not going to please welcome him.
Mr. Adams, earlier on, quite obviously, you were not greeted with welcome arms by Kevin Nash and company. Conan, as a matter of fact, has challenged you.
Mean Gene, I want you and everybody in this building to do me a small favor. Go out, get yourselves a nice warm cup of shut the hell up, okay? And recognize who's standing here talking right now. Brian Adams, one of Hulk Hogan's main enforcers. Hollywood Hogan made the NWO. Hollywood Hogan made professional wrestling, and you idiots better remember that. Hollywood Hogan has done more for professional wrestling than the entire Wolfpack put together. Hogan has done more than the entire Wolfpack put together times 10.
All right.
Hey, you shut up, Baldy, or I'll shut you up. Conan, you want to challenge me? I'll gladly take you out, punk, because I'm just too big, too bad, and way too sweet.
I think we know where this band stands. I thank you very much, gentlemen. Stay tuned. We're going to be right back with more Nitro live from Indy. Whoa.
It was a war.
I won that match.
You didn't come out on top. That ain't my fault.
Quit running from the truth.
What I saw was Benoit, who was the ref, Mickey J, in the line of fire.
Oh, he kicked Mickey J in the back of the head.
You go on and on and on about how I took advantage of the situation while you were tending to Mickey J, and you knocked out.
And that's when you, Chris Benoit, suckered me and did what you did. You got the cross face on me.
Crippler! Got his face!
You say I tapped out.
You know it. I know it. The people know it.
He's tapping out! I think, though, he tapped out!
I knew that I was inches away from the ropes.
You know I won the match.
I got up, and I tried to kick your head off, sucker.
It kicked in! All upside kick! 1, 2, 3!
You owe me another title shot.
Miss Lamborghini, I'll give you a title shot.